Welcome back. In this new novel, Lillian Boxfish Takes a Walk. The main character is based on the real life of Margaret Fishback, the highest paid female advertising copywriter in America in the 1930s. Mm-hmm. Gotta love that. Now, the story paints a portrait of a changing America from the jazz age to hip hop, from the Great Depression to the onset of the AIDS epidemic.
That's right. And joining us now is the author. It's Kathleen Rooney, and she is the founding editor of Rose Metal Press and founding member of Poems While You Wait. We're excited to chat about all that. Good to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
I love it. Before we get to some of those other cool things that you're doing, this book, first of all, I was talking about the fact during the break with you, the tactile feel of this book is just so, like, I love touching it. It's cool. And that I feel like it fits the sort of feel of your story.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, it's got French flaps and deckle edges, and it's about a woman who's from a time when even the details had details, and so I think it very much suits the character that it was based on.
Well, and talk about her, this Margaret Fishback, that's who it is based on. Yes. Talk about her story, who she was, why she was important to talk about.
Yeah, she was truly the highest paid female advertising copywriter in America in the 30s, and she worked for R.H. Macy's, the department store that's obviously still around, and her big innovation is she figured out how to be funny in advertising. She was the first person to use comedy, which sounds mind-blowing now because everything tries to be funny, but she was the first person. And they thought at the time that if you made fun too much in your ads, it would offend the consumer and make them not want to part with their hard-earned money, which was serious, especially during the Depression.
Yeah.
But she figured out a way to make people feel they were laughing with, not being laughed at.
Well, and I think that's probably important during the Depression is to make people feel like you can have fun still.
Yes.
What was her background?
So she was from sort of the Eastern Seaboard, the Washington, D.C., Baltimore area. She went to Goucher College, and she came to New York City in 1926, just starry-eyed and looking to make her fortune. And advertising was one of the few white-collar professions where women could really sort of make a killing. And she sort of reveled in that. She wasn't afraid of wanting to be the best, and she rose to the top.
That's it's amazing. Cool. Not only have you, you know, honored her story, who she is, and a lot of the facts, but you've also added this element that is about her sort of walking and exploring these urban landscapes, which is something you do in your life as well. So you kind of brought yourself into this character.
Yeah, and so I wouldn't say, I mean, it's obviously historical fiction. Mm-hmm. It is not autobiographical, but the, you know, facet of me, I think every author puts a little bit of themselves into their work. And so I do love taking long walks. I live in Chicago, and so I'll take, you know, like 8 mile, 10 mile, 12 mile walks. And I think going by foot through a city is the best way to see all the details and meet the people and realize that talking to strangers, which Lillian does a lot, is more fun and less scary than you might think.
Yeah.
Right. Did you learn, like, while you're writing this and going through the process, did you learn a lot about yourself and not, I mean, sometimes you can take a walk and not think so much about it.
Yeah, I think it sort of, you know, played up natural tendencies in me. I'm, you know, I don't know, I think it's that Midwestern thing. I'm really like,
hi, how are you?
Chatting people up.
Friendly.
Really wanting to know the answer, not just, you know, hoping people say, oh, I'm fine, but really wanting to hear what they have to say. And so I hope, you know, I hope first and foremost it's a fun read, but if people look for themes and things like that, I hope it makes them want to take a walk and talk to people that they don't know.
Yeah. How does poetry come into play in this?
Yeah, so she was also a light verse poet, so she wrote these very Dorothy Parker-esque, witty, rhymed verses. And she actually, it was at a time when you could sell your verses and make significant money, so she was in The New Yorker, Vanity Fair, Saturday Evening Post. And so all the poetry that's in the book is actually by her. So I have to put a thanks out to her son, Tony Anthony Antolini, who gave me permission to use his mom's material, because one of the things I hope is people rediscover Margaret Fishback, the real inspiration.
Right.
Right. I want to discover her. That's
great.
And poetry is big for you, too, because you'll do this as well for people, right?
Yeah. I do Poems While You Wait, so it's in Chicago. My friend Dave Landsberger and Eric Plattner co-founded it with me, and we set up our typewriters in a public place where people don't expect to see poetry, and for $5 and a topic, we will write you a poem on that topic just in about 10 minutes or so.
What's one of the coolest poems or one of the coolest poems you've written for?
Yeah, so I wrote, this kind of blew my mind, but in 2015 I got to write for Theo Epstein of the Cubs. And so he came and asked for a poem for his son. So it was about penguins and math because his son apparently.
Was he young? Was he like 10?
Yeah, he was, he was a little kid.
Okay.
So he may have moved past that by now.
Never know.
Probably. Did you know it was Theo at the time?
What's hilarious is I did not, but Dave and Eric, who are big sports fans, were sitting either side of me, just like losing their minds.
Going, why did he pick her?
I was like,
Why not me?
Oh, his name's Theo. And they're like, oh my
gosh.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Not only are they discovering poetry, but probably typewriters too.
Yes. Yeah.
People are like, what is that thing that she's working on?
A laptop without a power cord.
Yeah, weird.
Yeah, totally.
You just rip it right off and hand it to him.
Yeah, hand it to him. Yep.
People can meet you today, 2 o'clock at the Frank L. Weyenberg Library. That's in Mequon. And at 6:30 tonight at Elm Grove Library. That's where you can get a copy of Lillian Boxfish Takes a Walk. Do that there. Also, you can go to her website. It's KathleenRooney.com to find out more, or even potentially get a poem for yourself.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
So cool. Thank you so much, Kathleen. That was wonderful.
That is great.